Welcome to another video. In this video, we will study about the chronic kidney disease. It is the abnormality of kidney structure and function which is greater than 3 months. It is associated with irreversible reduction of excretory and endocrine function of the kidney, and the amount of GFR is less than 60 ml per minute, and the markers of kidney damage are hematuria, proteinuria, or anatomic abnormalities. Now, the epidemiology of CKD. It is about 10% of adults in USA and increased risk in African Americans. The causes of CKD include diabetic mellitus, hypertension, glomerulonephritis, interstitial nephritis, congenital diseases, vasculitis, and urological diseases. The clinical features of CKD include it is often asymptomatic until the later stages of life. It includes volume overload and hypertension, peripheral edema, pulmonary edema, uremia, the accumulation of urea and creatinine, fatigue, weakness, loss of appetite, headache, uremic fetor, pigmented spots, pruritus, anemia, uremic pericarditis, pleuritis, asterexis, which is the tremors of hand when arms are overstretched, encephalopathy, the disruption in brain function, peripheral neuropathy, GI disorders include nausea and vomiting, and increase the risk of infection due to leukocyte dysfunction and increase in bleeding tendency due to platelet dysfunction, the abnormal platelet aggregation and adhesion. CKD also include the mineral and bone disorder, abnormalities of bone and mineral metabolism. It also include renal osteodystrophy, weakness, fracture, bone pain, avascular necrosis, electrolyte and acid-base balance disorder. Sleep disorders include somnolence, sleep apnea, restlessness, leg syndrome. Now, the stages of CKD include two. These are according to GFR categories and persistent albuminuria. According to GFR, it includes the amount of GFR which is ml per minute. If the GFR is greater than 90 ml per minute, it is in G1, and according to the subsequent categories, it is categorized into G2, G3A, B, G4 and G5. And in the same way, the persistent albuminuria, it is categorized in A1, A2 and A3. Now, the management of CKD include two types of management, with diet and medical management. Prevent the hypertension and volume overload by sodium restriction, low protein diet, potassium restriction, phosphorus restriction, and avoid extraordinary magnesium in the diet. The medical management include the medicines which cure hypertension, ACE inhibitors, loop diuretics for hypertension, statins for dyslipidemia, vitamin D and calcitriol for hypocalcemia, and sevelamer for hypercalcemic and hyperphosphatemic patients, sinacalcet for hyperparathyroidism, sodium bicarbonate for metabolic acidosis, and erythropoietin, IV iron and RBC's transfusion for anemia. And for the clotting abnormalities, chiroprecipitate are given and dialysis until the renal transplant is available in end-stage renal disease. And now the vaccinations for CKD include pleural pneumococcal vaccination for every 5 years, influenza vaccine which is given annually, and hepatitis B in susceptible patients. Now the last, there is a mnemonic for CKD. It includes nephron, N for low nitrogen diet, E for electrolyte monitoring, and P for pH metabolic acidosis, hypertension, RBCs manage anemia, and O for osteodystrophy, and N for nephrotoxins. Thank you. This is the whole chart, whole detailed chart for CKD. I hope this will be very helpful for you. If you want